Welcome back to the channel, guys. Today we are taking a look at the Seed Studio T1000-E, the MESHTASTIC version of their SenseCAP tracker. This is actually a MESHTASTIC node. It's about the size of a credit card, but a little bit thicker. It has a really cool see-through case, and on this side you can see the battery and the magnetic USB connector, and also an integrated GPS. On this side we have the power button, the piezo buzzer and the LED, the ambient light sensor, and it also has a temperature sensor. And it incorporates LR1110 LoRa module and Bluetooth module. The device is IP65 rated, it means it's dustproof and watertight against light pressure water spray. This is also the reason why we have this really nice magnetic USB connector. The piezo buzzer can generate basic effects for on, off and incoming messages. I use a simple keychain with a quick release, so the device is easy to mount to a backpack or to your belt or something similar. With heavy use, the battery lasts about 2 days. Here I'm using T-Deck to send a message to the device. Let's take a look at the next Seed Studio MESHTASTIC device. This has been available for a while, but now it supports the MESHTASTIC firmware. This is the VO Tracker 1110 dev kit for MESHTASTIC, and it can be used with different accessory modules. The LR1110 LoRa module and the Nordic NRF52840 are included on board. There's also inbuilt LoRa, Bluetooth and Wi-Fi antennas. The dev board comes with 3.7V rechargeable LiPo battery for portable use, but the board can be also powered with USB cable. IPEX antenna connector allows the use of external antennas via patch cable like this. I got few modules with the board. First, the Grove 0.96-inch OLED display and the Grove Air 530 GPS module. Using a board like this for MESHTASTIC development and testing makes life easy. You can mix and match any modules you want, so it's perfect for experimenting. Here we have a very standard 128x64 pixels OLED display. And the support board looks to be of good quality. I also received a dedicated LoRa antenna. And this is how you assemble the VO Tracker dev kit with the previously mentioned modules. We'll start with the display module. Connect the display to the I2C port. Next up is the GPS module. let's connect the GPS module to the UART board. External antenna connects to the upper connector. Attach the LoRa antenna. And that's it, we're done. It's ready for a test. I really enjoy the mesh detector tool in the new T-Deck interface. See my tutorial how to install the development firmware. You can get a case for the board from the Seed Studio, or you can 3D print one yourself. You can download the files from VO Tracker product page. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already done so. Thank you and have a good one.